Welcome to the first daily talk here on the couch. As you all know, one of the things my brother specified in his will was that I should act like him after his death, just for a little while, just a couple of months. And, you know, I don't understand this wish, but I have been imitating him, you know, and a lot of people have probably met me and like, oh, there's Seth. And, you know, to be honest, I am not really a lot like my brother. Aside of the fact that we look exactly alike, that's pretty much the only similarity. Me and my brother just don't have a lot in common. And it hurts when someone comes up to me and is like, Seth, you know, sometimes it just becomes too overwhelming for me. You know, I'm not going to lie. I just have to, like, run off and just, you know, try to fight back the tears. But, you know, they come anyways. I'm not going to lie. I'm okay with talking about that kind of stuff. I mean, I've lost a brother. I mean, anyone would feel that way. But, you know, just yesterday, I was on the stairs, and my teacher, Seth's teacher, really, asked me to do a Cockney accent. And I stopped, and I remembered how he used to always do Cockney accents, and it was like he was right there with me, you know, his spirit, and I didn't know what to say. And finally, I ended up doing one. I don't even know if it was very good or not, and she just sort of nobbed. But, you know, it's things like that, just like other students coming up to me and like, Seth, Seth, and I'm like, I'm not Seth, but okay, I'll play the part. And that's the thing, I'm not him. It hurts to have to act like him. And this whole thing has just been so painful, and you know, it feels it's never going to be over. I'm never gonna wake up and there's Seth's gonna be. As far as bringing him back to life, Captain Crooked's How to Cheat Death just tells you how to live forever. It doesn't really say anything about bringing back the dead. I mean, I guess the man in gray could bring the dead back to life, but good luck trying to get something like that to help. And honestly, I don't even know if Captain Crooked's How to Cheat Death is just a real book or whether it's just a whole bunch of nonsense. I mean, I will confess, in my own life, I've seen some crazy things, but I don't know, you know, it gets confusing. There's always a chance something might not be true. You know, that's the problem whenever you're just, like, living in this world. But I do miss him. And I know he's in a better place. I really do. I believe there is a better place. I don't know what it is. I'm not really that religious, but I do believe in a better place. That's today's talk. It was a lot of fun, right? I sit alone with a pig.